Hello, I'm JindaLee. I'm a musician who's been working with 12x12 to release some NFTs, and now I'm doing an interview for International Women's Day. I first heard about NFTs maybe about a year ago. Initially, I kind of just read these big headlines about how some crazy tweet was being sold for $6 million or something like that, and I thought, that's crazy, I should get into that. Originally, I kind of understood it just to be more for art, and now I'm seeing how it's coming around in the music industry a lot more. And in the last year, I've done so much research, and having made a couple of my own, I think it's quite a huge learning curve, I think, for most musicians and most artists to go from pretty much zero to 100 in a very short amount of time since we've really like been exposed to the new form of art. And then to making them myself, it's been interesting and fun, and like I think it's a really amazing way for artists to take back a part of their music and a part of their distribution that's been held in a way from us for so long with different companies like Spotify. And we can now have more authority over our own music and also integrate different forms of art together, which I think is a really cool way to collaborate in an artistic world. And let's see what else we've got. So I do think NFTs are amazing. I think it's a really cool thing. I think it's nice also to have a short form of digital art that then has short clips of music and maybe the potential of having longer things added to it. I think it's a really interesting world that's like fully developing as we step into it, which I think is fascinating and fun to be along on the ride for. And as far as the added value in the music industry, I think it has a great value. I mean, I've been in the music industry now for like 15 years, I guess, and there's been so many different ways that music has been released. And I mean, initially starting with always making CDs and trying to sell them at shows and online, and just every time that I put an album out, which has been I make about half as many CDs and records and just kind of start selling things digitally because that's generally how people wanna have it now. And I think to have this NFT as a way of also taking in and selling music is really interesting, and it has like a lot more potential to give back to the artists and gives just in general more strength to the authority of the artists rather than the distribution agencies and their sectors. I think it's cool, and I think it has a lot of potential for the future. I'm just reading the notes here. I'm hoping you'll edit these nicely. So what's still missing when you think about NFTs? How can they become even more interesting to your fans? To what extent do NFTs need to be changeable? I guess I'm interested in how things will continue to develop with NFTs. I think that there's things that we don't even understand or potentials of ways to make them, ways to experience them, whether that be through a more virtual reality way or through more specific ways that you can actually make it really personalized, so it's made even specifically for one person. Which is fun with music too, because it's also always changeable and developable, and you can really make it personalized. And with an NFT, I think that's what I think would be really fun and interesting, especially for fans that want maybe to have in the old days when people would buy, like, there were so many of these specific like t-shirts. You could only get this one t-shirt from this one band, and then the next time that they would tour it wasn't around. I think fans have always wanted to be able to have the specialized thing. And the future, I think, of the NFTs is to make them more personalized and more individual and even more rare, maybe, which I think would make them more interesting to fans, and even in a way that's some ways could be a collaboration with the fans to make something that is like for them specifically. I think interaction with fans and music lovers has always been like an interesting part of making music. I mean, that's why we go on stage and that's why we play things for people, is to feel this connection, this interplay between artist and observer. It feels like if you have more integration between what the observer is doing and what the artist is doing, you get to have a more fun and integrated experience with art. I mean, we write our music for ourselves, but we also write it for the people that love it. And I don't know, when I'm writing music, sometimes I think about certain friends or family who really would like that one song, and I know that I write it in a way that I feel is sometimes for me and sometimes it's for the people that I know care. Okay, what are the current deficits in the music industry and can NFTs help to solve them? Yes, I think the current deficits at the moment are the big guns who have so much say over when music is heard, what playlist it gets on, who has the most plays, and how they get paid is really messed up right now. I mean, I with non-specifics, most of the kind of hierarchy of musical distribution and streaming is just absolutely in the wrong funnel down effect. It's not really reaching the artists and it's not really paying back in the way that it ever was meant to be. I think NFTs could really solve this issue. I think they're a way of having a lot more control over how people hear things, and I think making it more like an interplay between artist and fan and listener is just, it's a way into the future with that. I mean, ideally we can stop using these big gun streaming platforms and start actually finding ways and apps that are helping to interplay that better and to make it more of a thing that the artist holds and not these big companies. NFTs are definitely a way into that future for sure. Do you think NFTs will become established, or do you see them more as a short-lived hype? I'm interested to see what happens with NFTs. I think that them becoming kind of different forms of codes and ways of having, I mean, in your NFT wallet and in your gallery, I do think that they won't be short-lived. I think they have a long future, and I think that the way that that's going to happen is probably in ways that we have no idea and can't imagine at this moment in our lives, but I'm really interested to see where that will go, because I definitely don't think it's short-lived, but I do think it will become very different. I think it could be much more 3D, maybe more of a interactive thing, something that is like something you can play with or change, which will be cool and interesting. Maybe even using it as ways to play music. I think there's a huge future in it. Okay, what does it mean to you as a woman to be in the music industry? Oh, wow, okay. As a woman in the music industry, I think, God, it's just, there's been so many ups and downs, and it's been interesting. I mean, I think it's super important to be a visible woman in the music industry. We, especially in every realm, being in the side of producing and electronic music is definitely like the side of things that has very few women. I mean, I started out more in singer-songwriter in folk and rock music, kind of into indie music in my later music albums was, yeah, it was more like indie rock. And then I decided to go into doing producing electronic music, and I really felt intimidated by it at first because I think it was such a male-dominated industry. And I think it's just absolutely so essential to be working in that and showing that there's so much more potential for many, many more women. And I think that's happening, which is wonderful. And I'm excited to see what comes in the future with lots and lots more women doing that. Yeah, I mean, I'd say it's been something that it's like an uphill battle all the time, and to remain visible and fight for that visibility has been something that I definitely have done in my life, but I wouldn't trade it for anything. I think it's a part of the game, I guess, at the moment, but it's changing, and that's really good. Yeah, I guess that's mostly all I have to say. Yeah, I'm excited to put out more music with 12x12, and I'm excited to make more NFTs and see how that goes. And I'm also recording and producing and writing kind of all at the same time my upcoming album, which will be another electronic album, and I'm excited for it. So it's really coming soon. It's all in the works, and the inspiration is flowing in as we speak in this stormy, stormy, rainy winter weather. Much love to everyone.
So I think one of the most interesting things that are happening with Web3O on the topic of NFTs and DAOs is NFTs to me are just one little thing, part of a much bigger thing. And yes, experimenting and exploring what you can do with NFTs is interesting as a creator, and on decentralized networks, which means everything's transparent, and suddenly the topic of trust and privacy become really interesting. But I am really fascinated by what's happening with communities forming DAOs, and it's impossible to get into Web3O without having very philosophical conversations that we should all be having anyway. But I think Web3O has really highlighted some of these topics that we should all be thinking about, which are, how does anything we use technologically impact us individually, collectively, societally, locally, globally, environmentally? They're all such huge topics, but they're all really important to have. How are we going to use AI in ways that benefit us? And what are some of the catastrophic impacts that they can have so that we can at least be aware of them? How does all of this impact us emotionally, mentally, physically? And within communities that are forming DAOs, what is really interesting is a transparency of the conversations that are happening about, you know, things like systemic issues and centralized ways of doing things that we no longer want to repeat. And so decentralization, I think, then offers this opportunity to experiment and also find just people from everywhere who share the same values, the visions, and the goals. And you know, there are, the uplifting side of it happens when people are talking about, you know, universal basic income. How could we form a DAO from this community, for this community, that looks after everybody's well-being? Could that be possible? What are the sustainability options of that? I think that's where things get really interesting. So NFTs are just like an interesting way, I think, for artists to explore and contextualize how to present work, because I found myself thinking differently about how to contextualize everything I do, because there are a lot of methods and processes to what I do that I get asked a lot. And so it's actually helped me to break down my work into bite-sized pieces in the form of NFTs. And I am exploring how to use NFTs as social tokens, or just, you know, ways to get into, say, a private metaverse where they can experience more of my work. And I personally miss the days when I would buy an album, a physical album, go home and have a whole experience just dedicated to this piece of work. And, you know, everything from putting it onto a vinyl player or cassette tape player. And I miss all of these tangible experiences. And while at the moment, digital life is proving to be very intangible, at least in terms of like things we can touch and feel in our hands, and, you know, our senses, the way we experience life between physical and digital are becoming very, very liminal, and we're just like coexisting in this weird, mushy space. So with this upcoming AI audiovisual album, there are lots of different pieces, and just going back to the topic of DAOs, which is where my head spends a lot of time contemplating on, I think the first step for me is to do a series of NFTs with all my collaborators. I have brought in a very wide mixed groups of people who are from different backgrounds, practices, so that we can have a very diverse conversation about these things, and hopefully we can try to figure some things out together. And I think that's the other thing about decentralization that is really empowering in a way, is that it is offering communities to really be outspoken about what they are not okay with. You know, seeing things like when a centralized, capitalistic, harmful, toxic behavior tries to make its way through to decentralized platforms, what's interesting is to witness how things are getting immediately booted out. And that's quite wild. I mean, it really is like the wild, wild west out there. But if you have, you know, your communities of people and you're really supporting each other and you're building these strong values, and you see some stuff that's not okay, you can actually get people together and it's like, okay, this is out. And I think another really important thing to keep in mind is that as long as we stay focused on the connectedness, what is this doing for us humans to stay connected, and our well-being as well, I think that is where the focus should always be. And whether these technologies live the test of time, we don't know. No one knows forever about anything. But I think what's more important are the takeaways of these conversations that are happening. How can we hold on to these values? How can we hold on to these connections that we are creating based on these conversations, so that when and if whatever technology helped bring us together dies for whatever reason, we can still continue. And that is, I think, how I'm at least contextualizing everything. And I don't know anything, or I know a bit, but it just feels like there's just so much to unpack, and I still don't understand every marketplace, every NFT platform thinks differently. They showcase work differently. File sizes are different. The type of artists and creators are different. And it's a lot to take in. And so that is also why I decided to create this AI audiovisual album release as a co-creative effort as much as possible within the Web 3.0 space. And I'm not abandoning the traditional methods of releasing the album. I'm just doing it in different stages. And it's all research that I'm also happy to share at the end of it. And I guess, .. we'll see what happens.